This is a stone slinger truck, and I'm going to be delivering 3 loads to a job site where the foundation will be filled with 3/4 inch clear stone
using this machine. Stone gets filled up in the top. It's got a main conveyor belt right here. It travels all the way up to the back of the truck. And inside, it's got a piece of metal that'll raise up like this or up and down. And the gravel will be poured on top or any type of material. And you slowly let it up and let it pour on this conveyor, which starts turning. That's the fan to cool down the hydraulic system. And then this is another conveyor belt, which swings out. There's a giant boom on it. And the material from here will fall into here. And the material will fall into this conveyor belt. And this is a higher speed conveyor and will allow you to shoot to great distances all the way over to that dump truck in front of us. It's a very fast and efficient way of spreading different types of material and leveling it out. For example, foundation like I'm doing today, or this is for a house or foundation for a driveway, soil on lawns, and mulch and stuff like that.
Just delivering three loads of clear stone.
Yeah, it's just getting from the back stuff over here.
And what?
Yeah. All right. Because it's a little bit smaller over this way. That's like 3/4 bigger. But yeah, do you want coffee?
Oh, I don't drink coffee, but thank you. Drank it a couple times in my lifetime, but never stuck to it.
Whatever, hey, use your own. I can't live without it, so.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'll meet you down over here at the smaller pile.
Okay, sounds good. Okay, got the weight of the truck on the scale, empty, and then I'll come back and weigh the fully loaded weight. This is a giant scale you drive onto, and you know how much material you've purchased. Good. closing my tarp on the box. Building a expansion to the building there?
Yeah, there's two more cans coming and we're gonna put those trusses way up there.
Yeah.
Over them.
Cool.
You know where?
I got this one here.
Oh, that's yours.
Yeah.
You're 14, what, 350?
Yeah, empty.
That's three quarter?
Yeah, that's all for John too. And there's two more. After this.
Did you want more in there?
I don't know, it seemed like the way you load it, as full as it could get. Why it seems light to you?
It's 14.
14 tons?
Yeah.
Why, too lightweight?
No, I don't care.
Should be okay.
Yeah. It's not a good for more next.
It's full to the rim.
Yeah.
It just has to maybe
move
it over a bit.
Again.
Yeah. double clutching every gear, not floating gears. You press it when you switch out of gear and switch back into gear. You press it lightly, so it's double clutching. Some people just do it, let off the accelerator, then do it. But if you read the Eaton Fuller manual, it's an Eaton Fuller transmission, it says to prevent the most wear is to double clutch. And I've read about people saying the guys who double clutch then their truck fleet and didn't double clutch, there's a difference between how long their transmissions lasted. Double clutchers lasted a lot longer. Buttons are to help brake the engine. It's called an engine brake. I'm going around 12,000, and then I can rev it up again and then shift into lower gear.
you're driving a truck like this, you're always constantly moving your feet, your hands, your arms, keeping this truck on the road, switches, checking your mirrors, everything like that. So it's very labor intensive driving a big vehicle like this. And then the ride quality is, it's okay, but it's pretty bumpy. Make sure you're revving above 1400 RPM, or else you won't be able to get into that lower gear. So you really have to be thinking to synchronizing your gears or listening to the engine. reset. Didn't have enough power to get up there. Number 39. Okay, let's see what we got here. Garage edition. PTO so I have hydraulic power. Set my acceleration. How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you.
We gotta wait for inspection before we put anything in.
Oh, so it hasn't been done yet?
No.
What time do you think that's gonna happen?
They said before 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
So who knows?
What time are you at now?
10:45.
Yeah.
So we just have to sit tight.
Alright. So anyways,
top of the insulation.
Yeah.
Right? All the way along. He said full loads only. So if you get close and you only need a little bit, don't bother going back for a little bit, because we got a track in there with an excavator. So we'll top it up.
So you mean if there's only a little bit that needs left,
yeah, don't worry.
Just leave it? Alright.
Like, unless you're going
three loads is what you're asking for, though?
Is that what he's asked for? I have no idea.
Something around there. Yeah. You're the one who made the call? Or
no.
Oh, I see. No.
So in that little pocket has to get filled up.
Yeah.
And obviously in there.
Okay. Nothing on the outside. Yeah. Decent amount of water in there.
Hey.
Decent amount of water in there. You guys just did the excavating?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they want to pump out up the chart. So.
Yeah.
So the edge of the driveway, you're kind of off the on the grass.
Yeah.
Just keep it over. Try to maintain a little bit of a
yeah.
The grass. Oh, wait.
Am I trying to get you more work, you know?
Hey?
Trying to get you more work.
I don't think we want that kind of work.
No? Alright, well, I'll just wait around then, I guess. I knew this was gonna happen. These guys are waiting for inspection. They got a truck here. It's cost them the money just sitting here. It's 10:45. I'm a little bit early. They said around 11, so. He doesn't want me to track on the driveway that's already been driven on either. It's got lots of rules. That's okay. I'm subcontracted on this, so. Said yesterday, these guys, I told my buddy to tell these guys, like, arrange timing to have the delivery when they're sure the inspections are done, because then you get people complaining that they have to pay for a truck sitting here doing nothing, stuff like that. I have to wait around, even if I get paid, kind of like just sitting down doing nothing. Thank you.
this guy, it could be an hour, he could be 2 hours, so I don't know if it's gonna be worth it for these people. Gonna have to cut this video here and check what time it is and see what's gonna happen.